Hey there friends, your houses should be totally painted and this is an extension lesson where we're going to actually learn how to make FMS logo make sounds. So let's get cracking. The first thing I want to teach you is that there is a command called sound. And if you do a square brackets, you can put a frequency in, and the frequency I'm going to use is 261 because I learned that that is the frequency for C, which is a common C. And then this is a duration. I don't know if you'll be able to hear this on my computer, so do it on your computer as well. And when you press enter, it played that sound for 100 milliseconds. If I make it 200, same sound, but it lasts longer. And what you can do is, using this technology, you could actually make music.
Make sure you give those a quick test, and then you can move on. To make this slick and fun, we need to store our notes as their own words.
To do file edit, and I'd like you to create a command C, or the note for each letter. To do that, you simply type sound, and then you do your brackets, and we need to find these codes, like 261 is middle C, and then I'm going to tell you to do them all for 200 milliseconds. When you do file save and exit, if you do CCC, it plays those three notes together. Once you have created C,
we'll need to start creating the other cool notes, and this website will help us out. To find the cool notes, I'd like you to simply go to the HLModTech website and then go to Programming Logo, and down at the bottom you will find the piano note frequencies. You'll also be able to find this in the description of this video.
And this page is pretty awesome because it shows us a keyboard. And then it pounds into our heads that most piano stuff starts at middle C. And middle C's got that value I told you of 261. We can't do the 0.6. But what I'd like you to create is, you can see here they show you A to A with C in the middle. I think we should start with C and do C, D, E, F, G, and A. When you get those created by doing that same file edit that we did back here, and I made C, once you've got those all recorded, you can make a song by just putting your letters and let them go. That's how we made our fun songs. So you can fiddle around, you can make a new word called my song that does that. All right, this is where it gets fun. You need to pick a simple song that you know has no bad lyrics and stuff like that, and you need to come tell me, Mr. Harmon, I'd like to search for this song. I'm going to pick a super simple one, and then I'm going to show you what to type. So make sure, A, you've asked for permission, and then B, follow these steps. I'm going to do happy birthday notes. When I hit that, it'll show me the notes for happy birthday. If you don't see them, like on Wiki Answers or one of these easy ones, or, and you know, you could also put piano notes. That's a smarter way to search it. And then when you find those, you need to go in and look at it. I would look at this one. So I'm going to do open in new tab. And I'm going to also bring up the images. And what's nice about these, when I look at the notes, it tells me that happy birthday goes GGA GCB with a pause. So check it out. We go back to logo and we do GGA. What was that again? GCB. So I go back to logo, GCB. And then let's listen. I don't know for sure if that felt like happy birthday to me, but that is how you track down a song and start putting it in the commands called happy birthday. Now, what we might have to change is the length of our notes. So I'm going to look at that music quick and see how in happy birthday. See how these two notes are connected. Maybe I need to do a 400 millisecond happy birthday to you. Maybe in that'll make it help solve it. But that's what you do, is you use the notes from one page to help track it down. See what you can do for making your song. Ask me if you got any questions, and I hope you have fun with this. Remember, if you need any more notes, you may just simply create them by going back to our page and making the notes. This is called the fourth set of notes from C to A. So if you were to make these, I'd call this B3, A3, G3, back to C3. These would be called 5, 6, and 7. Those are how they're numbered on some piano stuff. So see what kind of song you can make, and let's have fun with this. Good job, and get to work. All right, just a heads up. I went down and looked at relevant answers here, and as I looked, I found that there are other answers that people said were good, whatever I had, where it starts with G. I don't think it's right. Listen to this one. This one actually sounds like Happy Birthday. I didn't do all of it because I don't know if I have the high note, but when I go back to logo and I just paste those letters in, I'll let you have a listen. You can see that sounded a lot more like the Happy Birthday we play. So just remember, whenever you're trying stuff on the internet, don't trust everything you see. Keep looking until things actually seem right. There's always justification for a good sniff test to make sure that it seems like it's doing what it's supposed to.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the last part of this amazing project is you should make a new word with your song. So I've got a song I created called Twinkle. And then when you're done, you'll be able to play it and prove just how epic your musical skills are. Friends, I hope you had fun with this crazy lesson. If you did, please hammer that like button. If you had any questions or comments, please put them down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Mash that subscribe button and click notifications if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new movie from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Happy programming.